This is StarTalk.
Bancroft coming to us from Earth.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, Dr. Tyson, in your opinion, who would be the most scientifically accurate and believable superhero with superhuman abilities in relation to real-world physics and counterpoint the most unbelievable and inaccurate, and why?
Yes.
And he is coming to us from Brisbane, Australia.
Okay, cool. So I think the most reachable superhero that's out there is Batman. Because he uses real devices on his utility belt.
Exactly.
And there's nothing there that you just say, oh, that can't happen, or he couldn't have done that. Or, you know, yeah, he's got some special materials, but that's okay, because his company makes
He's a billionaire.
Yeah, he's a billionaire.
So and his company is working for the government, developing experimental technology.
And he's got
the
stuff
military
that you don't have.
Absolutely.
So for me, he's the most realistic superhero. And Robin as well. He's just an acrobat in tights. Okay. All right. So... Right.
Or at least that's their cover. Oh, you know we know the deal. Hanging around with that young boy all the time, putting him in underwear. Living at your house, your big billionaire mansion. We know the deal. We know the deal. Oh, yes, that's my young ward. Oh, is that what you call him? Oh, your young ward. Oh, okay. Okay, child services won't be called because you're a billionaire and you have a young ward, okay? Let me do that. I am up on charges.
I swear I've never thought about it that way. Nor did I ever think that Bert and Ernie were a gay couple.
Right.
There's a whole, or that Tinky Winky was the gay one out of the.
Yes.
You know, there's a whole literature on
who, what, right, exactly, who okay. And what might be gay.
Who and what might be. I even forgot what I was talking about.
So you were saying that he is the most realistic is Batman.
And he's more real than Iron Man because the energy source that Iron Man is drawing from. To concentrate that much energy in one place, you would basically vaporize everything it was touching.
Right.
So,
and the other thing too is when you think about Tony Stark having this power source inside his chest.
Right.
Okay. Let's be honest. Let's just hook him up to a city, and forget it because that's amazing.
Right.
Why is this guy flying around in a suit instead of powering New York for free? But go ahead.
Right. So you can't concentrate energy. Anything that you've ever used that has a lot of energy going on with it gets very hot very quickly.
Right.
That's what energy does. Right. If you fire a gun enough times, the gun gets warm. It can't even get too hot to touch.
Too hot to touch, yeah.
Right, right. And cannons in the old days. In fact, they used cannons firing cannonballs, and the fact that the cannon kept getting hotter and hotter and hotter to discover and come to an understanding of how heat worked. A physicist would say, "You know, can we, while you're fighting this war, can we
come in here and measure?"
measure. And they thought there was a substance called caloric, which was a fluid that would be heat. And if you put caloric from one thing to the other, then that thing would be at a higher temperature. Oh. And so there were early ideas where we were intellectually sort of machinating how this would work. So Tony Stark, while I think he could wipe the floor with Batman.
Right.
If I had to be one of those, I'd definitely be Tony Stark.
Yeah, because you're both billionaires. So, hey, why not, right?
Well, they're both billionaires.
That's what I'm saying.
Right, right, yeah. They're both. Yeah, pick the billionaire.
Pick the billionaire you want to be.
Right, right. And so, definitely, but it's the energy, the concentration of energy is not real.
This is StarTalk.